Amen.
Amen.
I said amen.
Amen.
God is good.
All the time.
And all the time. More especially.
Amen.
All right. Maxwell, stand to feet. Go and wash. I don't want to see any.
We give you glory. We exalt you because you are God alone. There is none like you. You are the reason for this season. You are the cause for our lives. Be enthroned this morning in our midst. Take the preeminence over this gathering this morning. Let your power be revealed. Let your glory fall. Let the unseen to function be released. In the name of Jesus Christ, we bless you, Lord. We worship you.
In Jesus' mighty name. Someone said, Amen.
Yeah.
This morning you will leave here with your miracle.
Yeah.
I said you will leave because it is written in the Bible. But we want to look at who was lost, where was lost, and how did he end up? Who was lost? Now we come to understand from scripture that lost was a nephew to Abraham. It was a nephew to Abraham. According to the book of Genesis, chapter number 11. Read for the verse number 27. Genesis 11, the verse number 27. Now, these are the generation of Terah. Terah begat Abraham. Now, and Ham, and Haran begot Lot, and Haran died before his father Terah in the land of his nativity, in Ur of the Chaldees. And Abraham and Nahor took them wives, and the name of Abraham's wife was Sarah, and the name of Nahor's wife of Milcah, and the daughter of Haran, and the father of Milcah, and the father of Issachar. All right. If you read the verse number 31, it says, and Terah took Abraham his son, and Lot the son of Haran, his son's son, meaning grandson. All right. And Sarah his daughter-in-law, his son's Abraham's wife, or Abraham's wife. And they went up with them from whom of the Chaldees to go into the land of Canaan. And they came unto Haran and dwelt in Haran. Amen.
Yeah.
I said amen.
Yeah.
The Bible says that Lot is a nephew to Abraham. So in short, Abraham is his uncle, because your brother's son is your nephew. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And the Bible makes us understand that after God has visited Abraham and spoken to Abraham in the book of Genesis as well, the verse number 1 says, now the Lord hath said unto Abraham, get thee out of thy country, and from thy kindred, and from thy father's house, unto a land that I will show thee. This was to Abraham, not to the whole family. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
The promise was unto Abraham, not unto Terah, not unto Lot. But somehow, we come to understand that Abraham chose to carry Lot because Lot's father, Haran, died before his father would be there. The father was called Terah. So Lot's grandfather is called Terah. And Lot's father is called Haran. And they came and dwelt in the land called Haran. They left the land of who you are and came to the land called Haran and dwelt there. And that's why God appeared unto Abraham and said unto him, leave your father's house, leave your family, leave your kindred, go to a land where I will show you. Go and leave the land where I will show you. And he left. Praise God. But while he was going, Lot
Where is he? It is from Lot we get the word looking. Lot means heavy load. Lot means burden. Lot was not born again. Lot did not know God. Lot had no covenant with God. But he followed Abraham because Abraham thought, I will convert this guy for this guy to become a believer after a believer. And many of us are sitting here this morning. We have carried a lot of loss around us. God is talking to you. Go to this place and I'll make you a great place to say, Lord, follow me. And when Lord told me, Lord is the one that weighs you down. You're not able to accomplish your purpose because you have a loss, you have a heavy burden, you have a heavy load around your life. And you come and stumble up to progress in life. Tell your neighbor, let Lord go. I can tell you, tell the neighbor, let Lord
go.
Hallelujah. Wherever God said Abraham to go, Lord told him. Because after my son, there's no one to take care of him. There are people who are not big boys, they can take care of themselves. But many a times we bury ourselves to carry them alongside and think that without you, they won't make it in life. There are people, no matter what you do for them, they won't get saved. If you want to cut your head for them because they tell you you're a fool, why should you lie to me? Because the American man that who I am, that is, I will change and nothing will change me. That is the spirit of loss. And today it is being manifested in the church. Just as the spirit of Cain and the spirit of Bar is being made manifest in the church. The same way today it is being in the church. The spirit of loss is the spirit of envy. The spirit of love is the spirit of jealousy. That's the kind of spirit he carries. Who has put his hand up? He wishes of his hand to prosper. He wishes of his hand to excel. He wishes of above his hand. And that's a very dangerous thing for any man to do. If somebody is the one giving you a daily bread, and you feel you should be on top of the person to be down, that's a dangerous thing. It's a demonic entity. And it is today in the church. It is seen everywhere. Not outside. Where the church is there. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I said praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
If you read the rest of the form, you don't have to see that of Genesis 12. So Abraham departed as the Lord has spoken unto him. And Lot went with him. Can you imagine that? Lot went with him. Lot followed him. And Abraham was 75 years old. When he departed out of Haran. And Abraham took Sarah, his wife, can you imagine? And Lot, his brother's son, and all his substance that they had gotten. And the souls that they had gotten in Haran. And they went off to go into the land of Canaan. And into the land of Canaan, they came. The promised land. He went with Lot. Went with Lot. Listen to me. Any habit of love around you will only tend to destroy you. It won't take you anywhere. The spirit of love is usually known as the spirit of Ingrid. There is a man called Ingrid. When I saw him, I said, oh, you're called Ingrid. His name is Ingrid. He's so grateful. He doesn't give gratitude to the people who have in life. Ingrid. He had contention with Abraham. He stood with Abraham to fight with Abraham. Why? Because he felt Abraham to be excel more than him. But through Abraham, God bless Lot. Because God's covenant is with only Abraham and not with Lot. God said, I will bless you until you become a blessing. You will be a blessing to nations. Whoever blesses you, I will bless. And when Lot was there, because Abraham pull him alongside, the blessing came on him, and the fact was because of Abraham himself. Because at this time, Abraham had no child, so he wished about all things that when Abraham died, I will succeed him, I will take over his estate, I will take over his properties, and I will become a child. And I will give him possessions, God. Because what has been resurrected is going to become something.
But something happened. Someone say something happened.
Say something happened.
Something happened.
In the book of Genesis, and the text, the rest of the one. Text the rest of the one. Quickly.
And Abraham went out of Egypt, he and his wife, and all that he had. And Lot was in Canaan. Abraham left Canaan, went to Egypt. Why? There was famine in the land. And when Abraham came out, he came up and out. Egypt is down. He went down to Egypt. And when it was time for him to experience the hand of God, he came up and out. Someone say up and out.
I said people in this land, many of them are in it.
Give me bread today. The woman tell me there is no bread.
When you saw you tell you a little man, they follow me.
Give me bread to her. Tell me tomorrow you have no bread to give.
He will tell you you are a very wicked person. Although the doctor said he wanted. Hallelujah.
And between her husband and my husband, for we be brethren, we are brothers. We are my son. How can you fight me? Then hear this. It's not the whole land before thee. Separate thyself and bring from me. If thou would take the left hand, then I will go to the right. Or if thou depart to the right hand, then I will go to the left. Can you imagine that? Abraham says to him, choose whatever you want. You are the son, you Jesus. And he read the verses, and Lot lifted up his eyes and look. You see, every ungodly person looks to the natural, the physical, not the spiritual, because there's no spiritual eyes. Instead of praying to God and telling God, show me where to go. You have no prayer. Because there's no relationship with God. And that's what many people have to do. Many times, they choose what they want. I remember when I was praying to start this commission, I went to Komoso, it's my mind. It's almost half of this much, half of the commission. Very nice. I came to the place. I was busy renovating. I was looking for a well-to-well metal gate like this one, the kitchen, so that I always have my use there. Somehow, some people live at the ground. When they heard I was going to live at the ground, and they closed and told the person, take the place, don't give me. Frustrating. 1 week to myself, the owner called me. I said, why? I don't want you to be. Why? I'll be back. No. Please, keep my key. I don't want to see this. I was wondering, what happened? Why? Tell me, you're not a boy. Go and pray. Go and pray. Come and give me a place. What? What? I said, okay, I'll tell you. Tell me everything. I'll pay you. I said, I'll pay you. I'll pay you. You did not pass the door. I was walking the sun. I said, hey, God, what place? Because I prayed there. Every morning, 7 o'clock to 2, I'm always there. I possess the land. I don't know who ever will be there. You went to the box. Okay, Raymond went to the box. But I got this giant box. About how many? 4 women, whatever. Okay, heavy ones. And the place became very bright. And I was waiting to paint the place. But I wanted to sack everyone's house in that place. Because the place is going to be the house of God. In 2 weeks. I really want to start meeting the classroom. Classroom is October. I remember from classroom years ago. I knew how to go back. God said, go back and learn. And thank God, I only learned for 8 months. How many months? Everybody go to school for how many years? 15 to 20 years. They are learned only for 8 months. After 8 months, I'm not in the classroom. Today, see what God has done with us. Some of them are now watching us on TV. I don't think if I'm working, I'm working with somebody. Who would have gotten the land? This place is a strategic place. It's a strategic. Abraham told us, choose what you want. And he chose and left. He looked and saw the green grass. I love that area. In fact, I'm going to this. One of the best life is you. Choose whatever you want, but I like you. And Abraham to the other side. After Abraham said, I'm taking here, God came down. And said, Abraham, I will make you mighty. I will bless you. I will make you great. Your children will be like the stars of heaven. Have you seen the sun at the seashore? That's how your children will be today. You know, the of God, I pray you will repent today. And his end was disastrous. Lot chose to live in the world. Now listen to me, I said your choice. What you choose to eat, what you choose to wear as a believer, as a church leader, someone who goes to church, will tell the world who you are. Lot chose, turn God, turn Abraham, that he was an ungodly man.
people who practice sodomy. Hope about them. Just live in their midst. And what did you hear? They told him, wrong, come, we have better conversation than you. Come and live among us. And they went and stayed. He now went to the house, built a house and lived there. And because he was unworthy, his wife was worse. His children were worse. Now listen to me. You cannot be godly and let your children marry unworthy children. Unworthy men. Lot had two brothers. They all were. They married alcoholics. People who drink and do all manner of things. People who practice lesbianism. They practice homosexuality. That's what they believe. And Lot gave his students out to that man. And they married them. They married them. But when the hour came for God to destroy the city, God knew Lot was on the heart of Abraham. So the Lord met. Must I not tell Abraham what I want to do? I'm going to destroy the city of the good world. Abraham said, yeah. My love. Wait. I'm going to have you. Will you destroy the righteous with the unrighteous? He didn't know that Lot was unrighteous. He didn't know that the wife was an unborn leader. He had no idea that Lot, after all these years, he still did, had not still changed. He wasn't repentant. He was not born again. He was not righteous. He only had the
They became a byword.
faith. Look at your life. Or not.
Are you envious of the Lord?
That's envy.
You see someone is wearing his coat. He said, ah! Please go to him. He's better than me.
Could he buy it? He got some. And when they beat you, you're like, hey.
I do it.
Envy is a crime. Is that what?
People who are envious, they practice witchcraft. The spirit of envy is the spirit of witchcraft. Lost!
Have this kind of spirit. He lost everything they have.
Lost everything!
People who are envious, they will lose everything they have. Including their own life. Envy, it leads to loss of life and loss of property.
I said that will not be your portion.
I command that the Lord will separate them from you.
Amen.
I command the angels of God to separate them from your life, from your destiny. In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
I said in the mighty name of Jesus. Oh Lord, help me. In any way I have manifested the attitude of loss. In any way I have behaved. When I have a big gratitude, have mercy, O Lord, upon me. And from today, you know, our young men and young women say, Lord, say thank you. When you hear something, they feel it's my right. They're supposed to give me anyway, so I should say thank you. It's like when the sun rises in the morning, how many people say, Father, thank you. Tell them what you say. Some people are suffering for the sun to come up. They look at it. Go down to Britain. Now, snow is falling. Everywhere is something else. People are freezing. Yeah, where me and you are still under the sun. And we complain, the sun is too hot. Someone the sun is too hot for them. They get it. She said, the sun is too hot. That's ingratitude. Ingratitude. Thank you for my life. Thank you for your goodness. Thank you for today. Thank you for everything you've done. Bless the name. Open your mouth. I can't hear you. Open your mouth, thank God. Bless God. Exalt Him. Honor Him. Glorify Him. He alone is worthy. He alone is worthy to praise. He alone is worthy to be exalted. Bless the Lord. Bless the Lord. Bless the Lord. Kaharama. Nebekaka. La Ruta Baka Vivas. In Tomogra Pagalakas. Yahadabandeya Vadivas. Father, we bless you. We glorify you. We magnify you. We exalt you. Libida Pranita Yatanus. Ekranata Lagamus. Thank you, Father. We give you praise. In Jesus' mighty name. Amen.
Amen.
You want to be the Lord. In any way, after like the Lord, have mercy upon me this morning.
Forgive me, Lord.
For not being grateful for the things you've done for me in the past, in the mighty name of Jesus. Okay, on your turn. Come to God.
Let God hear your voice. If not, for Christ to God,
confess you have done. But he didn't know what mercy was. in the mighty name of Jesus. Open your heart and talk to God. Talk to God. In the mighty name of Jesus. God shall not down power us. In the night.